Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. So welcome to another episode. Today we're gonna analyze as usual the Bitcoin price, because it looks like that we're forming here a bearish pattern which can take us at least towards $10,000, and also we're gonna compare it to the DXY chart. So before we start with the content, don't forget to subscribe to our weekly Bitcoin giveaway. The subscription video is popping up at the end of this video. You have to put the hashtag, your comment, and of course your Bitcoin address to participate on our giveaway. And also, if you need any kind of trading exchanges, you find all the recommended exchanges down below here in the video description. With my links you can get some bonus, and also if you're new in the crypto space, you can open up an account, for example, on Coinbase or Swissborg, where you can get also some rewards if you open up an account with my link. And now let's start with the Bitcoin price here in the 1 hour time frame, because currently, as you can see, we are fighting here the 20 and 50 moving average. Also, the RSI is right at the 50 level. In my opinion, we are probably going to push higher here towards the $10,600 resistance here in the next couple of hours, because we are forming this potential rising wedge or bear flag after dropping here from this $11,000. So currently Bitcoin is holding here with this $10,400 support, and we are not able so far to break through this $10,600. I still think that we will see a possible breather here towards $10,700, and there most likely getting rejected and potentially see continuation to the downside towards 10K, because that is the next support if we are losing here this $10,400 area. And if we have a look into the Bollinger Band in the 1 hour, you can see that right now we're right in the middle line. So probably we will shoot up here towards this $10,600 to $10,500 level, test the resistance again, because this is also the top here of the Bollinger Band. And if you're getting rejected here, watch out for the support down here at $10,400. So the Bollinger Band here in the 1 hour time frame is perfectly lining up with our rising wedge. And also, as you can see, KST and MACD are looking quite flat here, so I still think we're gonna trade sideways here for the next couple of hours. Stochastic is shifted to the upside, so I think there is a high chance that we could see this $10,600 test coming up pretty soon, since we are now building up support here above the 20 and 50 moving average in the 1 hour. And if we go over into the DXY, you can see that currently here we are also in an uptrend. We are bouncing from the 50 level in the RSI, and we have currently the $94 level as a resistance. But most likely, if we're gonna have a big bounce here to the upside, we will also break this $94 in my opinion, because my target is still here to reach this $95 to $97 before the DXY probably is gonna top out, and we're gonna see a bottom in the Bitcoin price and also in the stock market. And we can go over into the 4 hour time frame in the Bitcoin chart, because currently you can see the 20 moving average lining up perfectly with our resistance up here at $10,600. Also, after being completely oversold here in the RSI, you can see that we're coming up here very close to the 50 level, and this is where then we're gonna have to see if we're getting rejected or not. If we can close a 4 hour candle above $10,600, then this could be a sign that we will see continuation, maybe even towards here $11,000, where the 200 moving average is lining up, and also potentially could top out here in the RSI. But if we are not able to close a 4 hour candle above the 20 moving average, I think it is clear that we will see continuation here to the downside, and this area up here at around $10,600 will be the top, at least for the short term. And if we have a look into the Bollinger Band in the 4 hour, also here you can see that we're still trading here in the lower end. So far we didn't test the midline at $10,600. I think most likely in the next couple of hours we will, also because the stochastic is in neutral condition, so we have some room left to the upside. And also MACD and KST are looking quite oversold currently, so here as soon as we're gonna have a bullish cross, we could fire up towards $10,600. And if we can really break this resistance up here, then maybe we could even shoot up towards 11K to retest $11,000. But I think here at $10,600 to $10,700, we will face the most resistance here and probably getting rejected. At least this is my expectation. And if we have a look into the DXY in the 4 hour, also here you can see that there is a chance that maybe we come down here to test the 20 moving average at 90 360. So this could lead into a big breather in the Bitcoin price. But if we're coming down here and have a nice bounce from it, which also you can see previously acted as a resistance and now could be the new support, we could see this little breather in the Bitcoin price. But if the DXY is bouncing from it, this will lead into bigger corrections in the Bitcoin and also in the stock market prices. In my own indicator, I got here a sell signal currently, so there is a still a high chance that we could see a little correction to the downside. So that's why be prepared that maybe in the Bitcoin price we will see a possible push to the upside in the next coming hours. And now let's go back to the Bitcoin price and open up the daily time frame, because here, as you can see, since we closed this daily candle below the 20 daily moving average, we didn't come up here to test it. And the 20 daily is currently right here at $10,700. So this is why I think if we are starting to trade within this rising wedge and top out here at the 20 daily moving average, so at our resistance at $10,700, here is where we most likely gonna face the most resistance and getting rejected, and possibly gonna lose also the support at $10,400 and start heading towards 10K, potentially even lower, towards our future gap, which is at $9,600, and at the same time maybe even come down here to retest the old strong resistance, which now should be acting as a support right where the 200 daily moving average is lining up here at $9,200. So this is where I have the most of my buy orders and also long entries if we are reaching those levels again. RSI is now also trading below the 50, so we still have some room left to the downside here before getting into very oversold condition. So that's why I'm telling you, my friends, most likely if this support here is not gonna hold, we're gonna see these price levels down here again at around $9,200. And if we open up the Bollinger Band in the daily, you can also see that currently we're right in the middle level. So if we see a push to the upside here, then watch out for this $10,700 to $11,000 resistance. But if already here we're getting rejected, then here the bottom is right at $9,960. This is where we're gonna find support if this $10,300 will not hold for now. MACD and KSD are still looking flat. We are still shifted to the upside, but if here we're gonna have a major drop towards 10K here, this will end up in a possible bearish cross and will take us even lower than that, in my opinion. And if we open up the DXY in the daily time frame, you can see that we're trading currently above the 50 and 20 daily moving average, and the 200 is up here at $97. So I still think if the DXY has enough momentum left to the upside, we will see a possible 200 daily moving average retest here and possibly getting rejected, and this will lead into a big crash in the stock market and also in the Bitcoin price. And if the DXY is getting rejected here at these levels, then this will be also the bottom for the Bitcoin and stock market prices, and then we can start to look again into big long positions and also buy everything in back into Bitcoin and all the altcoins that you want. Because if we zoom out, the DXY is still in a bear market. So as long as the 20 and 50 daily moving average are trading below the 200, we are in a bear market here in the DXY, and we will see continuation to the downside, even though a possible 200 daily moving average retest is in the card. RSI is also coming very close to overbought condition, but we still have some room left to the upside, and that's why I still think we will see some more pressure to the downside in the Bitcoin price as long as the DXY is trading above the 20 and 50 daily moving average. And now let's go over back to the Bitcoin price and open up the weekly time frame, because the weekly is still looking bullish. We are trading above the 20 weekly moving average, and also the RSI is above the 50. So even though we will see potentially $9,200 to $9,600 again, this could also end up in a big week to the downside. So as long as we're closing weekly candles above this moving average, so above $10,000, we should be still heading to the upside. And if we have a look into the Bollinger Band, you can also see that currently we are trading between the two moving averages. So even though we could lose this $10,000 support, if we drop here into the lower end of the Bollinger Band, the bottom is right here at $8,200. So even if we would drop towards $8,200, we will remain on our bullish way to the upside, and at the same time also create a higher low in the weekly time frame, which is very bullish for the long term. But at least for the short to mid term, we will potentially see those price levels again. MACD and KSD are looking like they could top out here and have a bearish cross incoming, and this could lead into a potential sell-off here, but take it as an opportunity to buy in and scale in long positions if the price is really coming down to those levels, because for the long term, Bitcoin is still the safest bet. So with that said, guys, I'm going to wrap it up for now. Don't forget to moon up the likes and subscribe to the channel here. Also, if you need any kind of trading exchanges, use the links that you find down below here in the video description. You support the channel and also you will get some rewards. And feel free to join also our Discord trading chat. You find an invitation link down below here in the video description. So thank you very much for watching, my friends, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.